My two cents, motherfucker.
What up, y'all? DC Fago Guy. Is Twisted emulating ICP? This is a response to Panic 17, who made a video last week on Carnival Spirits entitled, What If Twisted is Emulating ICP? So he gave a few instances where he feels like maybe Twisted was more or less kind of ripping off ICP or Psychopathic. And so I'm just going to kind of go through and give my response to each one and give the last one that he's got of what I feel is really kind of going on. So first off is the first instance he says where he feels like Twisted is copying ICP is the fact that Lex the Hex Master, the first new artist, I'm going to say new artist because, I mean, you know, you have Blaze and ROC. So the first new artist that we ever heard of is called Lex the Hex Masters. And that's very similar to Big Hoodoo. Well, it's similar to Big Hoodoo because of the Hex part. I don't think they're ripping off Big Hoodoo per se. I think what they did is they wanted to build on his name, because actually his original name was Lex Masters. So for some reason, they decided to go with Lex the Hex. They decided to rhyme with the Lex part, Masters, instead of, I mean, I've done a whole video about this, but they basically could have come up with a doper name, in my opinion, by calling him Lex the Ninja Master or some shit like that. They should have played off of the Master part of his name instead of the Lex, but I think that that's what they did. They came up with a different persona rather than Lex Masters. They decided to rhyme with Lex, therefore they came up with Lex the Hex. To me, they could have done something doper with his name, but it is what it is. I honestly, now that I, you know, months have gone by since they first announced him, I don't think it's a Hoodoo ripoff. It definitely seems like it, but the more you kind of dive into it, I don't think it's a ripoff at all. It's just, it was a bad decision of something they could have done that could have been doper. So the other thing he's got is the new album, or the other thing that kind of made him feel like that is the fact that their new album is called The Continuous Evolution of Life's Questions. Once again, kind of a weird, for me, that's a weird name. For Panic, he said that this makes him kind of think of The Marvelous Missing Link and the fact that, you know, you're looking for things in your life, and if you're looking for the continuous evolution of life's questions, who knows what that album's theme or concept is going to be, or if it even is going to be a concept album. The name suggests that it's going to be a concept album. Until it comes out, there's not a whole lot more that I can even comment on that, because just looking at the names of the albums, I don't see where it could be a ripoff. But to me, it's almost like the continuous evolution. It seems to me like what they're going to delve into is that psychotic gene, I guess you could say, that a lot of people tend to have. But once again, right now, I'm just kind of shooting out assumptions and speculations. So maybe this one was a ripoff. I don't know. I won't be able to answer that until the actual album comes out and I listen to it and hear the themes and concept behind the album. So that one's just, that's a plausible. That one's in the air. The last one, or not the last one, but the next one was the fact that Twisted's coming out, or came out, I should say. They've actually come out with it now. It's for sale. Is the new soda that they've got. Now with this one and the last one, I'm going to go ahead and tell you what the last one was. He said the final thing that made him really think it was the fact that he believes that they're emulating Psychopathic. And emulating, of course, means to match or surpass somebody, typically by imitating them. With the new soda, I think this was an opportunity. Who knows if they were approached by the soda company? I honestly do not know. I think this was just an opportunity to market themselves out there in a new avenue. Maybe they chose soda because of Fago. They figured maybe they could do that with the fact that a lot of Juggalos love Fago. They figured soda was a good avenue to try to market themselves. If that was their approach, then they did a horrible decision, because you just can't compete with Fago and their prices, especially when you have to have your product sold for $4, assuming that they're doing it to make their good profit margin. I don't think that was a wise decision. I believe that's the point of the soda. I believe they want to market themselves, and they felt that soda was a good way to do it because of Faygo and Juggalo's connection to Faygo. So lastly, do I think that Twisted or Magic Ninja Entertainment is emulating Psychopathic? I'd say yes and no. I'd say that they are definitely imitating Psychopathic. I don't think they're going to surpass them. That's my personal speculation. I hate to be kind of doubtful of Twisted and their capabilities. I'm not saying that they won't surpass them, but in my heart, they'll never surpass Psychopathic and ICP. But I believe the imitation is more of a that is what they learned from being with Psychopathic. It is what they have learned by being under ICP's wing. They've learned to market, they've learned to merchandise, they've learned all kinds of great trades from ICP. And I think being more or less the heads of Magic Ninja Entertainment, that's what they know, that's what they're going to use. And it does look very imitate-ish. It looks like they are imitating Psychopathic, which, kind of begs the question, are the Frankensteins now becoming clones, or is the Frankenstein more independent now and thinking on his own? And being the Frankenstein he is he taking what he knows from the master who created him? So there you guys go. That was my 2 cents response to Panic 17's video on Carnival Spirits. I will leave a link to that video. Go watch it and leave your feedback both here and on that video and tell us what you guys think. Do you think Twisted is copying ICP slash Psychopathic Records? Yes or no? Give us your thoughts. And thank you guys for watching.